Welcome everyone to another exciting tech review. Today we are diving into FocuSee, a powerful screen recording and editing tool designed to cater to the needs of content creators, gamers, educators, professionals, reviewers, and tech enthusiasts. If you are really like to this video, give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe my channel. First, I am going to show you how you can download this amazing tool. You can find the link in description. After by clicking that, you will navigate to this kind of window. In this window, you need to click on this free download button. And another thing is, this amazing tool is available for Windows users and also Mac users. So after clicking the free download button, your setup will be downloaded. My setup has been successfully downloaded. Now time to install this amazing tool. First, right click on your setup and click Run as Administrator. After completing the installation, you can find this tool by searching FocuSee. Now I am going to open this. In the left side, you can see FocuSee name and logo. In right side, you can see some shopping icon. By clicking that, you can see the pricing of FocuSee. After that, you can see the account icon. By clicking on it, you can log into your FocuSee account. After the account icon, you can see some clock icon. By using that, you can simply navigate your file history. After the clock icon, you can see the setting icon. Under the setting icon, you can see the about, check for update, then feedback, guide, and finally FAQ. After that, all things, you need to select your recording mode. They are providing three options for us. We can select full screen, custom, and window. Now time to choose device setup. It also have three options, one for web camera, another one for mic. Finally, we have option for speakers. In this time, I am going to use only web camera, but you can't see my face on it because I hide my face into the camera for this video. In here, I am going to use this custom option for this video. I am going to click on it and I need to select area like this. After selecting our custom area, we need to click on red color record button. In that also, they are provide some chance to change our device setup. I think you're not able to see that correctly, but don't worry, I will add image for that. After the clicking recording button, we can see the time count to start our recording. Now I am going to stop this FocuSee recording. After ending our recording, you can see this FocuSee editor window. In here, you can see video enhancement and cursor and camera. Under the video enhancement, first you can see the canvas size. By default, size is original. If you wish to change, you can change that one. And we have another option for custom. In that, we can select custom size for our canvas size. Actually, in that, they are providing some template size for us. After our canvas size, we can see the style section. In that, we have padding, inset, roundness, shadow, and finally background. By using this padding, we can adjust our padding in video. Like this, you can adjust your padding on your video. After that, we can adjust our inserts also. Like this, you can adjust your inset. In here, you can see some color icon. By clicking on that, you can change that inset color also. Like this, you can change that. After that, we can adjust our roundness. Like this, you can adjust your roundness. Finally, we can adjust our shadow also. Like this, you can adjust your shadow. And we can change our background also by clicking on here. You can see that we can change our background. And if you wish to add some color for your background, you can use this color icon in here. By clicking on it, you can change the background color also. Okay, now we can move to cursor section. In that, we can adjust our cursor size and cursor style and mouse click effect. I think now you can see my cursor. Now I am going to increase my cursor size. I think you can see that one. And also I can decrease my cursor size. Like this. And again, I am going to change my cursor size. Because when I am do any changes for cursor, you can clearly see that. Okay. In here, you can see they are providing 7 cursor style for us. Now I am going to check one by one. In here, you can see our cursor change like this. And you can see our cursor style is changed. And I am going to select another style. You can see my cursor has been changed. And this. And this. And this. And also, finally, we have this cursor style. Like this. And finally, we have mouse click effect. Now I am going to check that what are the effects we have. In here, you can see they are by default give us to none and default. I am going to check with this ripple and firework. I think you can see the difference. Now I am going to use this firework. I think you can see that difference. Now go to our camera section. In the top of that camera section, we can see the toggle button for show camera. Using that toggle button, we can switch on off our camera for our video. After that, you can see they are providing two camera layout for us by click on that. You can change your camera layout, and also we can flip our camera by clicking on this flip horizontal. You can change your camera layout. After that, we can see the camera size. We can adjust our camera size also, and we can adjust our camera roundness. And in here, they are providing us to another option for mirror camera. You can use that one also in your video. And we have another option for camera size during zoom. You can adjust that one also by your wish. Finally, they are providing two options for us. One is filter and another one is camera frame. I am going to select one camera frame. In here you can see my camera frame successfully added to the my video. I think our left sidebar is now finished. Now I am going to show you how to customize your zoom option. For that, you need to click on this blue color. After by clicking, you can see that option in left side. That zooming option, you can see the toggle button for disable zoom, and you can adjust the zooming level. In here, I am going to disable that, and we can see the difference. Now I am going to enable that, and I am going to play the video again. I think you can understand the difference. And also we can adjust our zoom level. I am going to increase our zoom level like this, and I am going to click this apply to all. Now I am going to play this video. I think you can see the difference. Finally, I am going to show you how to set spotlight for your video. In this video editing section, you can see the spotlight icon after the clip icon. First, you need to click on that. After that, you need to select area for apply the spotlight. If you wish to, you can adjust the roundness also by using this left sidebar. You can see I have added my spotlight. Now I am going to play this video for your understanding. In here you can see my spotlight is working. You can clearly see my selected area. Here you can see that they are providing sharing option that is available for only the pro version. And after that, now I am going to show you how to export our video. Before we export our video, we need to sign into FocuSee. For that, you can click on the account icon available on the right side corner, or you can just click on the export button. In this time, I am going to use my Google account for this. Then I am going to select this sign in with Google. Now you need to click on this Start FocuSee 1.0 and open FocuSee. Now we can export our video. If you wish, you can change this format, resolution and also frame rate, and you can provide any name for this, and you can select your save location also. Now I'm going to click this export button. Let's time to see our output.